Air. Now, when most of us think about these uncommon opponents, we go back to Super Bowl IV, Tulane Stadium in New Orleans. Hank Stram's troops, the field general, Liddy the Cool, leading the Chiefs with that seemingly unstoppable offense in terms of precision passing and a devastating defense that seemed to know the Viking play sequence better than Minnesota. Well, the Chiefs took out the Vikes that January day back in 1970 to win their first and only Super Bowl title. How sweet it was. Back with more pregame from Minneapolis in 2 minutes. Stay with us.
Dick Smith's Discount Ford Mart.
It's a holiday mega sale this week at Dick Smith's Discount Ford Mart. You'll get a huge discount on any new car, truck, or van.
Dick Smith's Discount Ford Mart.
Discounts up to $5,000 or more. Rebates up to $1,000.
Dick Smith's Discount Ford Mart.
There are no lower prices anywhere. Interest rates as low as 2.9%. Immediate financing. On-the-spot delivery. The Ford factory says we're Kansas City's number one dealer for customer satisfaction.
Dick Smith's Discount Ford Mart on 350 Highway in Raytown.
I don't think it's gonna fit the billboard.
It's gotta fit.
Presenting McDonald's double quarter pounder with cheese, with two juicy quarter pound patties of beef.
Okay, it fits.
Where are you gonna put the fries and the Coke?
The what?
With large golden fries and a medium Coke, it's our new double quarter pounder with cheese extra value meal.
Okay, fit.
Now where are you gonna put the arches?
The what?
What you want is what you get.
The double quarter pounder with cheese extra value meal.
At McDonald's today.
I remember the Christmas I tried to catch Santa Claus. I was 6 years old. I snuck downstairs after everyone had gone to bed. And I hid with my blanket, my pillow, even my favorite teddy bear. I was so determined to see St. Nick in action. Well, sometime that night, I fell asleep. My parents found me, tucked me back into bed. So I didn't see Santa that night. But the next morning when I woke up and I saw all the presents under the tree, I knew he had been there. From our family to yours, Channel 9 wishes you happy holidays.
The best truck news of the year just got even better. Not only can you get the best lease ever on any new 1994 Ford F-Series, now you can get the lowest financing rate of the year. 2.9% on any 1993 or 1994 model Ford F-Series truck. So whether you buy or lease, you won't find a better offer than this. Your Ford dealer has a good selection of America's best-selling pickups. But don't wait. This offer ends January 3rd. So hurry to get the best of terms on America's best at your Ford dealer today.
Looking across the Mississippi River into St. Paul, a pretty sight on a very chilly December night. But luckily, we are indoors at the Metrodome, where kickoff is just about 17 minutes away, and you'll see the game live right here on Channel 9. Tear up the turf. It's becoming a battle cry across the country. In Kansas City, the Royals are doing just that. They'll play on the real stuff in 1995. But will the Royals follow? Mike Walter did some checking, and here's his results of a very informal poll.
Another game, another injury. It's been that way all season long. Webster Slaughter went down last weekend on the turf in the Astrodome. It's becoming a familiar sight this year. Injuries are mounting, and people are counting. In fact, in Philadelphia, they are pointing at the turf and blaming it for several injuries, including this one, Bears receiver Wendell Davis. He went up for the ball, wasn't hit by a soul, and still blew out both knees. He blames the turf for his injuries.
I think all AstroTurf is bad, you know, my opinion. You know, I think that surface has caused a lot of people's career to end very early.
Some turf, it doesn't give it all at all. You know, and it's just tight. That's how a lot of guys blow their knees out on turf. And, you know, grass, you're not going to do that.
There can be little doubt that the turf takes its toll on teams, but no one knows that better than the men who work down in the trenches, the offensive and defensive linemen.
We hook up with guys 300 pounds, and we try to move them off the ball, and the joints have to take on a whole lot there because of that.
San Diego, I spent 5 years on grass, and my knees were never sore. And, you know, playing here and spending a lot more time on turf, you know, I've got a little soreness that I never really felt before.
AstroTurf beats up the body. It takes a lot of the players. And but I'd rather be on natural grass. I think that's the best bet as far as longevity of your career is concerned.
Reggie Reggie McElroy has been in the league for 11 years now. He knows only too well what kind of effect the turf can have on the body. His knee can speak volumes about what gives way when the turf doesn't.
My first knee injury came on AstroTurf, and it wouldn't have happened if I was on natural grass, because I was taking on a bull rush, and I tried to plant my feet. My feet didn't give, my knee joint did, and I had an operation that year.
McElroy says it took him a year to return to the field following that knee injury. And you won't catch a receiver like Tim Barnett singing the praises of turf either.
That turf will eat your skin up, you know, especially in the end zone, you know, down there where that paint is. So, you know, that's the thing, you got to fall exactly right, and you got to have your sleeves on, and there's always parts that you can't protect that can get burned.
But before you walk away thinking that no one wants this stuff, think again. There's always Nick the Kick.
It's kind of like a golfer who gets to hit out of the fairway all the time rather than the rough. It's just more consistent. It's even better than the fairway, though, because it's a lot more level.
At Arrowhead, it's almost always an automatic. But on grass, well, that can be a different story. It's hooking. No good. So the question is, does Nick ever wish he could have this kick over again? Only this time, at Arrowhead instead.
You can't change those things, but since we're in Arrowhead and we can change that, please, keep the turf, please, just for a couple more years.
I'm joined now live by the Chiefs president, general manager, Carl Peterson. Happy holidays. Congratulations on winning the West.
Well, thank you very much. You know, it's I'm so pleased for so many people, and particularly all those Chiefs employees. They've all worked very hard for this. But we've got two very important games to play.
I want to backtrack and address the issue of grass versus turf. Is the organization at this time leaning either way in that regard?
No, but we've been looking into it very seriously. We've got HOK doing a very exhaustive study for us. And we'll make a decision probably shortly after the first of the year whether we'll go with natural grass in 94 or the AstroTurf.
Minnesota at 7-7, a dangerous football team. They must win. What makes them good? What impresses you as you evaluate that team?
Well, it obviously starts with their defense. They've always played a great pressure defense. Tony Dungy of the Chiefs in here now as a defensive coordinator has done a great job with their defensive scheme. They give you a lot of blitzes, a lot of fronts, and they're going to make some bad plays, create some bad plays. Hopefully, we'll get some good ones to them.
Last week, some of the teams tried to sign players so some of the money wouldn't affect the salary cap next year. The Chiefs did not announce any salary signings. How difficult will it be to get under the limit next year for Kansas City?
Well, first of all, I think you know that I never announce any player signings because I think that's a private matter. The salary cap is going to create a lot of different scenarios for many teams next year. We want to be active in the free agent market. We've done some things I hope that are prudent in getting us here. It's going to be difficult, but again, with the new television contract, hopefully it'll be a positive for the Kansas City Chiefs.
You almost hinted that you might have signed somebody but didn't tell anyone.
Well, like I said, I don't reveal those things at this particular time. And right now, the important focus should be on us winning football games, not player contracts.
Carl, appreciate your time very much. Congratulations. Good luck.
Thank you, and congratulations to everybody in Kansas City.
Carl made a comment a moment ago about one of the signs way on the second deck. Dear Santa, next year, please send us season tickets so we can see Kansas City play at home instead of driving all the way to Minnesota to see the Chiefs do just that on the field. Well, more Channel 9 Chiefs pregame is ahead, including some players who are involved now in talk radio. Speaking of talk, since those guys are working this holiday, they wanted to spend some send some special greetings back home.
Well, I'd like to wish a Merry Christmas to my cat Claudius, because he's a hell of a guy, and my family, and just everybody that has a chance to be with their families. I think it's the greatest wish that you can have answered.
Yeah, Merry Christmas to Tiffany, Taniqua, and Tim Jr.
Well, I'd like to say Merry Christmas to my beautiful wife, Cynthia, and my gorgeous daughter, Ashley, and my new son, Joe.
Hi, I'm Len Dawson for Hy-Vee Food and Drug Store. The holiday season is always a busy time, so let Hy-Vee lend a hand. Our special holiday trays are sure to please any crowd. Delicious meat and cheese trays with fresh baked rolls and breads. Or try our shrimp trays and festive shrimp trees. Then top off your party with a scrumptious tray of cookies and pastries. Hy-Vee can also help with personalized gift baskets and special holiday flower arrangements. So this busy holiday season, shop Hy-Vee's 8 convenient locations.
Nate Dabrowski, penalties up, get out there.
Hey, but coach, I hadn't finished
finish my guys.
Oh, get out there!
Oh, penalty on number six, Zabrowski.
Guy's potato chips, with the real potato taste you won't want to live without.
Food Barn has made the Guy's choice. So stock up on the real potato taste of Guy's potato chips, on sale this week at Food Barn.
Stock up for the holidays with Pepsi products. 24-pack cans, now only $3.99 at Schnucks.
Hey, look who's here!
When the year ends, your Mazda dealer ends it big. Right now, you can get $750 cash back from Mazda on all V2300 trucks. Or a great lease on the exceptional Mazda 626 LX. It's time to save on a Protégé compact sedan with a special year-end $1,500 cash back now. It's your Mazda dealer's 10-day year-end clearance. But hurry, this special event ends January 4th.
At Chuck Anderson, Cable Dahmer, Pangborn, Laird Knoller, Superior Quality, and Blue Ridge Mazda now.
You're looking at a live picture of the home of Jay and Mindy Taylor, the Chiefs cornerback and his wife. He is here, she is there with a group of friends as Kansas City already clinching the division title in the AFC West, but Kansas City still in the battle for home field advantage. We'll find out how these folks enjoyed the game on ABC 9 News tonight after the football game. One way to measure the Chiefs' success is by listening to the radio. When Marty and Carl came to town, there was only one radio show, but as Kerry Kornacki shows us now, the Chiefs are flooding the airwaves.
You can turn the dial just about anywhere on your radio and find one of the Chiefs talking football. Because of the team's success, there are eight shows on the airwaves Monday through Friday. The week starts off with Derek Thomas, who has not one, but two shows on Monday. At 6, he hosts a one-hour show on 103.3 from the Marriott Ellis Plaza.
Myself, Neil, and Kevin Ross, we've had a show on KPRS 103 for the last couple years, and we wanted to continue that, and I wanted to venture out and do some new things, have a chance to experience a different flavor of show.
Turn the radio to 101 The Fox right after Derek at 7, and you'll hear General Manager Carl Peterson broadcasting from the tavern and top deck.
Telling statistic was their third down conversion.
My head coach Marty early on said that he was not interested in doing a radio show, a live talk in or call-in show, and I respect that, and frankly would rather have him do that on Monday nights. So that's why I decided that I would go ahead and do that.
On Wednesday, turn your dial to 980 KMBZ. Defensive lineman Joe Phillips has an hour show that seems to be a favorite for football junkies.
We are an attacking defense, and you know Tracy can support me on this. We have not changed at all.
The calls that I'm getting from fans, I mean, they want to know why this person is covering this person. They want to know why this particular play is working. I mean, there's some real avid football fans here.
While Joe is broadcasting from my brother's place, Bar and Grill in Independence, on Thursday night, it's tight end Jonathan Hayes at Zarda's Barbecue in Blue Springs.
I want to also mention that we have a couple young people here from Central Middle School.
It's a very mixed audience. It's a family crowd, basically.
Jonathan's show on KMBZ starts at 6 o'clock. Turn the dial at 7 to 101 The Fox, and you'll hear Tim Grunhard show live from the levee.
I think we got the guy number 19 who's been putting games away for years. So.
The show has really evolved in almost a cult following.
And then on Friday, there's Nick Lowry at 8:35 on KNHN.
Our biggest problem in Denver, in my opinion, has been we haven't been able to communicate the calls on the offensive line.
To me, most importantly, we get to tell people about the lives of the disabled and the opportunities that they're helping supply.
If the Chiefs' success directly affects the number of TV and radio programs the players are involved with, I thought it might be interesting to check out some of the other teams in the AFC. Take Denver. There are 3 TV shows along with 5 radio programs. In Miami, there are 10 shows, half on television, half on radio. There are also 5 more programs hosted by former players. In Buffalo, 7 players have their own television shows or weekly segments, 3 more on the radio. Houston has 14 on TV, 19 on radio.
Even the trainer has his own show in that town.
At the other extreme, a team like San Diego, where a lack of fan support means a lack of television exposure. Joe Phillips, who is now with the Chiefs, has his own show here. But when he played for the Chargers, no one offered him one.
Actually, no players in San Diego had a show. There wasn't really the interest in football there that I found there is here.
Most cities that do have player shows have one for the quarterback. Not here in Kansas City.
Joe particularly is not interested in doing a quarterback show, and again, we respect his privacy on that.
That's okay. There are plenty of talk shows on right now, and Kansas City fans just can't seem to get enough of their Chiefs.
I can tell you, out of all of the radio shows, the one that's got to be rated PG-13 is Tim Grunhardt over Fox. They get pretty silly every once in a while. Rejoined by Ted McKnight. Teddy, a final thought about this game. How do you size it up?
Well, I don't seem to be a pushover game for either one. We're still going for home field advantage, and the Vikings still have a shot to get into the playoffs in general. I think it may boil down to defense in the sense of special teams. I hope that's where we're going to come out to be the strongest. Obviously, we've got a good offense, but I feel that we have an opportunity of winning this game. I figure 3 to 7 points.
All right, Ted, thanks for your time. Kansas City, the fans over the corner when they sing the national anthem, at the very end, as they do at Arrowhead, they said the home of a Chiefs. There are many fans here tonight celebrating, hopefully, what will be Kansas City winning its 11th game this year. We're back live at about 10 o'clock with a post-game report. Vicki, back to you in Kansas City.
All right, thanks, Dave. Great job with the division title, you know, a sure thing. Now we want a post-Christmas gift from the Chiefs. We want to win, right? All right. Thanks, Dave. The weather has been nice today.
The weather has been nice today, but we're going to get a taste of what Minneapolis has right now. At Minneapolis Airport, the temperature is 1 degree below zero. At Kansas City's airport, we're still at 38 degrees, and that is radically
but
going to change.
Long.
Not for long, because the weather picture is going to change here in the next 24 hours. The cold air that has been up around Minneapolis, Chicago, Detroit is moving down toward us. Overnight low tonight, about 18 degrees. A few light flurries are possible. Winds northeast, bringing that colder air in. Let's check the forecast for tomorrow and look at the high temperature of only 23. Now, we will see a few little flakes of snow flying in the Kansas City area. As of right now, it looks like our air is very, very dry, and we don't expect any kind of accumulation from this. If you're driving down south, especially toward Oklahoma, Arkansas, Louisiana, and parts of Tennessee over the next 48 hours, you could run into some very slick road conditions down south. Look at the high on Tuesday, only 18 degrees, and in fact, the morning low on Tuesday is likely to drop into the single digits of the 8 or 9 degrees. So the cold air that the folks up north have been suffering through mm-hmm. is on its way down here to mm-hmm. visit us for a little while.
But most people will be in tonight probably watching the Chiefs game
stay
once this air moves in.
Stay hot with the Chiefs.
All right. Thanks, Bruce. Thank you for watching our Chiefs pregame and expanded KMBC 9 News. We'll be back after the game around 10 o'clock, postgame included at the 10 o'clock news. Good night and stay with us.
The best truck news of the year just got even better. Not only can you get the best lease ever on any new 1994 Ford F-Series, now you can get the lowest financing rate of the year, 2.9% on any 1993 or 1994 model Ford F-Series truck. So whether you buy or lease, you won't find a better offer than this. Your Ford dealer has a good selection of America's best-selling pickups. But don't wait. This offer ends January 3rd. So hurry to get the best of terms on America's best at your Ford dealer today.
Just like any medical problem, you have to admit there's a problem before you can fix it. So now let's talk solutions. The 12 hospitals of the Health Midwest System provide over 1,800 doctors and 2,500 nurses, which means your family will always be free to choose who provides your care. Healthcare is changing, but with Health Midwest, your future will be a healthy one.
When the year ends, your Mazda dealer ends it big. Right now, you can get $750 cash back from Mazda on all V2300 trucks. Or a great lease on the exceptional Mazda 626 LX. It's time to save on a Protégé compact sedan with a special year-end $1,500 cash back now. It's your Mazda dealer's 10-day year-end clearance. But hurry, this special event ends January 4th.
At Chuck Anderson, Cable Dahmer, Pangborn, Laird Noller, Superior Quality, and Blue Ridge Mazda now.
Regular ABC programming will not be seen tonight, so that we may bring you the following KMBC TV 9 sports special. This KMBC Sports exclusive is brought to you by your local Jeep and Eagle dealer, who invite you to test drive the new Jeep Grand Cherokee. By McDonald's. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today. By Southwest Airlines. Fly Southwest. It's just plain smart. By Price Chopper. Best food, best price every day. And by the Missouri Lottery, where the Chiefs are always winners.
I made you some tea, Chris.
Mm-hmm.
Don't get too comfortable.
Next.
You need to read the letter on the table.
Oh, but the game, Mama.
Santa, football can wait.
All right. Dear Santa, I'm writing on behalf of 52 friends. We've been very good this year. Once in a while, we're bad. Sometimes we get naughty. But usually, we're very nice. We have these wishes. Goodwill, peace, and joy to all men. Good health, especially for Joe. And most of all, a trip to the Super Bowl. Sincerely, Derek Thomas. Kansas City in the Super Bowl? Mama, get the elves. Let's saddle up. Rudolph, turn right. We're not going to Buffalo.
Chiefs have already clinched the AFC West for the first time since 1971, with both the Broncos and the Raiders losing earlier today. And they still have a chance for home field advantage throughout the playoffs. The Vikings control their own destiny by winning their last two games. They are assured of a wild card spot. With Green Bay and Detroit both winning today, the Vikings can no longer win their division, though. Good evening, everybody. Mike Patrick along with Joe Theismann. Great to have you with us. Hope you had a wonderful Christmas. Last week's come-from-behind victory gave Kansas City its fourth straight 10-win season. It's a franchise record. But that success in the last 3 years hasn't carried over to the playoffs. So they began their postseason preparation a little early this year, spring, in fact, when they signed a pair of future Hall of Famers, Joe Montana and Marcus Allen.
And, Mike, you know, these two guys have defined their career by big performances in big games. For example, Marcus Allen is out proving what he said all along. Give me a chance to carry the football, I can make something happen. He leads the Chiefs in rushing. He leads the AFC in touchdowns. Joe Montana, on the other hand, is considered the missing piece of Kansas City's Super Bowl puzzle. And they felt all along that they had the talent on this team, except they just needed a quarterback. Now, Joe has to stay healthy, which he has. And, oh, by the way, Mike, these two guys really know how to win in December and January, too.
Well, winning is the single reason that Jim McMahon was brought to Minnesota by head coach Dennis Green. But he is an enigma. His stats don't show his value, but somehow, when he plays, the Vikings are better.
Well, you know, Mike, Dennis Green didn't bring Jim McMahon here to throw for 300 yards. What he did is he brought Jim McMahon here, first of all, to win games in the NFC Central, which he has. He's 6-0. The second reason he brought him here is to get this team into the playoffs, which he has. Dennis Green feels that Jim McMahon is playing his best football right now, and he's going to have to for the Vikings to have a chance against the Chiefs.
Dennis Green, near the end of his second year, with a chance for back-to-back playoff appearances. He led the Vikings to a division title as a rookie head coach. And Marty Schottenheimer in his fifth year with Kansas City, and this season will mark his fourth straight playoff appearance. You hear so much about the home field advantage in football? Not this year. The Vikings, four straight losses at home. That is a franchise record for this club. And on display tonight, some of the best sack men in the business. Neil Smith from Kansas City. His counterpart on the other side, Derek Thomas. And for the Vikings, John Randall. Power from inside. And the speed rush of Chris Dolman. Kansas City Chiefs have won the toss and will receive as we start our ball game. And Fuad Rivas has it teed up at the 35. He has not been able to reach the end zone very often this year. Danan Hughes and Todd McNair are back.
You know, Mike, these Kansas City Chiefs are really dangerous on AstroTurf, especially when it's dry and sticky like it is here in the dome.
Rivas, a line drive kick, and that one will go out of bounds and give the ball to Kansas City at its 35-yard line. When Joe Montana has been healthy, he's been exactly what the Chiefs had hoped for. 7-2 as a starter, 12 touchdown passes, only 4 interceptions. Marcus Allen is not just playing out the string, he's become a go-to guy again, especially if you need points. He scored 15 touchdowns. John Ault finally made the Pro Bowl last year, even though he had played better in the past. This season, he's back among the elite of the league's pass blockers. Montana throw on first down. The short dump off complete to the tight end, Jonathan Hayes, and he's taken down at the 40. Let's look at the Viking defense. John Randall led all interior linemen in sacks last year with 11. Amazingly, didn't make the Pro Bowl. This year, he's even better with 11 and a half sacks. Jack Del Rio might be the best plan B acquisition anybody in the league made. 147 tackles to lead this defense. And Vincey Glenn, another veteran acquisition 2 years ago, 10 interceptions in that span, 5 this year. He's tied for 4th in the conference. Montana has it picked off. Intercepted by Anthony Parker. Only the 5th time this year Montana has been intercepted, and Anthony Parker, a young man who led the World League in interceptions when he played there.
He's a third-year man. Arizona State came here from Indianapolis in a Plan B acquisition. He just reads Joe's eyes, moves right in front of the receiver, makes the pick. Kansas City fans are looking at this game and saying this strongly resembles the start against San Diego last week when Joe got his first one picked off.
They went down 17-0 and then had to fight back to win that ball game. And a great start for the Vikings at their own 49. Gordon McCarter, the referee.
We reset to 25. Reset to 25 on the play clock. Thank you.
That's the 8th interception for the Chiefs this year. Now, that's the second fewest in the league as a team to Dallas. Of course, Troy Aikman having an MVP season.
Scotty Graham will get the carry, maybe about 2 yards. Take a look at the Minnesota offense. Jim McMahon does not rack up the big numbers except for one. 70% of his starts have been wins, second only to Joe Montana. Scotty Graham, the latest in the succession of Viking running backs this year, but no lack of success. He had 139 yards last week. Up front, Tim Irwin makes his 180th consecutive start tonight, tying the legendary tackle Ron Yeary. He hasn't missed a start in 11 years since they built this indoor facility. Short and complete. Chris Carter down to the Kansas City 43-yard line, a couple of yards short of a first down. Albert Lewis on the tackle.
Dale Carter, Albert Lewis, the corners of the Chiefs, they play everybody physical and tough. Look at what Carter and Lewis are locked up in. I mean, obviously you're allowed to chuck within 5 yards. I don't think you're allowed to maul in 5 yards, and Albert Lewis just did a mauling. But still, I mean, he wasn't holding him. He just kept contact on him, and that is legal.
Very physical defense. And
McMahon to throw on third and short. Deep sideline, Ismael, he made the catch, first down. The rookie from Syracuse.
Right part of your screen. Now, keep an eye on the footwork at the end of this play. Look at the job. Nice throw by Mack, but look at the job by Ismael. One down, two down drag. He has really started to develop into a clutch wide receiver. Good reception, first of all. Left foot, right foot drag. Very well done.
McMahon. Under pressure from Thomas, got it off, but incomplete. Good coverage by the linebacker Tracy Rogers on tight end Steve Jordan. The crowd wanted a flag. They won't get it. For Kansas City, Neil Smith has used his speed and strength to become one of the game's most feared players. He leads the NFL in sacks with a career-high 15. Derek Thomas had 14 and a half sacks last year, equaling his average of his first four seasons, but the number is down this year, 8 through 14 games. Pro Bowl corner Albert Lewis has had at least one interception in each of his last five and has 38 for his brilliant career. Second and 10, Vikings in Kansas City territory after the turnover. McMahon to Scotty Graham out of the backfield. And Lewis has had a busy first quarter. Takes him out of bounds with what appears to be just shy of a first down.
You know, Mike, Minnesota's game plan tonight is that they have got to be productive on first and second down. Because of the physical nature and the coverability of the corners of the Chiefs, they know that they can wind up in third and long situations. McMahon had three touchdown passes last week, only has six for the season, but has shown the kind of production that they've expected from him because he has a complementary running game and short passing game.
Third and one for the Vikings. Third and short, they just haven't gotten it done this year. That goes back to all the injuries at running back. They'll try it again, and Graham diving forward looks like he has the first down. Terry Allen, of course, hurt in preseason. Robert Smith was hurt. They've used Barry Word, Roger Craig. And here is a young man, a free agent out of Ohio State, actually the fifth guy they've tried in this spot, and he is doing the job. And they will measure.
Okay, this is my just before the new year prediction. They made it by about 4 inches. We haven't had a lot of these this year, Mike.
No, we haven't. In response to a flood of letters, you will not sing this week either.
Thank you very much. They did make it. All right, a little bit more than 4 inches. Dave Adolph, the defensive coordinator of the Kansas City Chiefs, put in really a 4-3 defense. When they got Joe Phillips from San Diego, they really felt like he was the guy who could anchor the middle for him and allow Salamuda to move around and make some plays.
Graham on the delay. To the 10-yard line. Dale Carter spun him down, but Scotty Graham running hard and showing some speed to the outside.
I'll guarantee you what this is, Mike. Lonnie Marks, number 51, misjudges Scotty Graham's speed. But the Minnesota Vikings are a very trap-oriented offense. Watch this. They're going to pull and trap this way. He's going to come up, and Graham's going to swing it outside. There comes the trap, but now you see when March closed, I don't think he gave Graham enough credit for having the speed to get outside.
Graham again cuts it outside. This time gets only a yard. Here is a young man who was working in a pharmacy and was a substitute teacher when he was signed to the ball club. Now, you don't think this has been a great Christmas for him?
Unbelievable. And you know what's funny? When we talked to Marty Schottenheimer last night, he says he wishes he was back selling pharmaceuticals instead of playing football for the Vikings. You know, he's a really aggressive runner, and I think that's what Dennis Green likes about him. He doesn't dance around. He finds a hole, and when he hits it.
Second down from the 9. Can't get there. Nice coverage by Dale Carter.
Jim McMahon was going there right from the get-go. He got his when he, he The thing that Dennis Green talked about earlier, Mike, is pre-reads by Jim McMahon. What he can do, what he sees before the snap of the ball. He knows he's got AC one-on-one on Carter out to the left. You see him look to the right. There was no doubt he was going left. He just looked away to set the pass up. Just hung it out over AC's fingers.
Third down. AC comes to the near side again. Chris Carter in the slot to the top of your screen. Here come the Chiefs on the blitz. And overthrown, Jordan, the intended receiver at the 7-yard line. They'll have to settle for a field goal try. Charles Mincy, the safety blitz.
I think this is a great move when you've got physical corners that you can let go one-on-one. Watch the safeties. Here they are. They're going to come in and fill the gaps. They don't have enough people up front to block everybody, so somebody's going to come free. There's the free man. The back can't get over. McMahon does exactly what he should do. Try and get to an outlet man. Wouldn't have been a touchdown, but he saves a sack.
This will be from 27 yards for Fouad Rouvet. And they'll never get it off. Movement up front.
Neil Smith, number 90, just a little bit anxious. Now they're trying to decide which one. It's against the Chiefs, just a question of who.
Encroachment before the snap, middle guard defense. Half the distance, still fourth down.
Looked like Neil Smith was not in total agreement with the call.
There he is in the middle, number 90. What he did, see, he saw movement by the center, though. I tend to agree with Neil on that one. He saw movement, reacted to the movement by the center, and made the move. Now, obviously, nobody else saw it.
That will take it down to a 22-yard field goal. Still fourth down, just inside the five. And Fouad Rouvet has now hit 28 straight inside the 40-yard line. Joe Montana, with only his fifth interception, sets up the field goal.
Bottomless blues and screaming yellows, in sounds that shake you to the bottom of your heart, in images clear as crystal and brilliant as ice, in faraway worlds as close as your fingertips. These are what dreams and Sony Trinitron televisions are made of. Make one come true for you. It's your life. Isn't it worth a Sony?
This man just woke up in a Residence Inn hotel room. What are his options? He can A, make a cup of fresh coffee in the kitchen. B, walk all the way over to the living room area and start a fire in the fireplace. Or C, shoot some hoops. Okay, let's see what he does. D, none of the above. Residence Inn by Marriott, the next best thing to home.
ESPN's Sunday Night NFL is brought to you by McDonald's. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today. By Sony, the official video electronics company of the NFL. And by Residence Inn by Marriott, the extended stay hotel.
3-0 Vikings early first quarter. Dennis Green was a 49er coach in Joe Montana's glory years. Here's how he thinks you have to defense the three-time Super Bowl MVP.
Because Joe is a master of the pre-snap look, you have to make him concentrate on that pre-snap look longer. If you're tipping off your coverage because of a personnel, could be a defensive end. If you're tipping off your coverage because of a linebacker, if you're tipping off your coverage because of the way the cornerbacks play, before the ball's even snapped, you really have problems. So we have to make sure that Joe has to read the coverage on his drop and not be able to take advantage of a pre-snap look.
And yet throughout his career, he's probably seen every trick you can throw at him. With the return across the 20, about the 23-yard line. Joe, what do you think of the idea of
of everybody being in the exactly the right place for a pre-snap read?
Well, they don't actually, Mike, they don't, not everyone has to be in exactly the right place. A lot of times, either a safety or a corner will give you an idea whether it's man-to-man or zone. That tells you a side of the field that you want to work to based upon what your pass routes are. So you're not necessarily having to look at a lot of people. All you have to do is look at one. Now you see as Joe Montana comes out of the huddle, he's surveying where the safeties are located. Now this looks like a 2D coverage to him. So he's got a play that he feels will work against it.
Marcus Allen with his first carry to the 26-yard line. A man whose career was in the doldrums in Los Angeles. For 2 years, with great disfavor with Al Davis. They were really going after each other. Finally got the chance to play for someone else and has proven, as you said earlier, what he had said all along. He can still play, 11th all-time rusher. He scored 15 touchdowns this year, a remarkable comeback season for him. Kimball Anders, the fullback, wrapped up by Del Rio. About 2 yards shy of a first down. Of course, one thing that the Minnesota Viking defensive line will miss tonight, the presence of nose man Henry Thomas and Esra Tuaolo, who started a week ago against Green Bay, in his spot in the middle of that Minnesota defense. Henry Thomas on the sideline. And a new acquisition, Bobby Abrams, number 50, has checked into the Minnesota defense on third and short. Montana to throw for it. Has time. Anders to the 39. It's a first down. Carl Lee made the tackle on Kimball Anders.
Carl Lee on the tackle. That's a Chiefs first down.
I think what distinguishes Joe Montana from so many other quarterbacks in the league is his ability to find secondary receivers. He fakes the draw, looks down the field, doesn't have what he wants. Now he steps up, realizes he only needs 3 yards for the first down. I'll take the fullback out in the flat, pick up the first down, and let's move the chains.
John Stevens, number 21, is the new running back. He's the deep man, and he'll get the carry. Stevens barrels his way out to the 45-yard line. If you remember the name, but you haven't heard about him for a while, he was out of New England, where he had such a great rookie year. Made the Pro Bowl with over 1,100 yards rushing and has knocked around ever since, and they were very happy to pick him up.
The reason they were happy to pick him up is because his last stop was Green Bay, where he got familiar what we will call the West Coast system. Green Bay, San Francisco, Kansas City all running.
Second and four. Diving forward, a little shy of the sticks, it appears.
You know, Mike,
the 49.
I get so excited when I see Marcus run. He has a signature way of running the football. Everybody's got a little thing that they have of their own. Tony Dorsett had a great lean. Emmitt Smith has a great lean. Marcus Allen, what he does is he will always finish going forward. Even if you trap him for what looks like a 3-yard loss, it's only going to wind up as a one because he finishes going forward.
Jim Grunhardt had said he is the kind of player every team needs, whether he plays well or not. He's a great leader. Allen, first down into Minnesota territory.
Boy, did Al Davis make a big mistake. He really did. I mean, they went, you know, he was unselfish blocking for Bo Jackson. He did all the things that was required. There's a guy for the Los Angeles Raiders who was voted by his teammates for 3 years in a row as the toughest guy on the football team. I think the Raiders made a big mistake not giving him a chance to play football and be the consummate Hall of Famer, future Hall of Famer and professional that he is.
Well, for years, he didn't make a peep about the way he felt he was being treated. Todd McNair now checks in as the single setback on first and down. First and 10, rather. McNair on the toss sweep. Line of scrimmage and no more as the Vikings swarm. John Randall led the charge.
It's interesting what Joe Montana's decided to do and Paul Hackett, the offensive coordinator. They started the game throwing the football. Joe's receivers and everybody, they're still learning. So Joe figures if Dennis is going to play games with him, they got a big offensive line against a quick defensive line without Henry Thomas. Let's run the ball and use a three-yard first down philosophy.
Second and 10 here. Montana swarmed under. The sack goes to Dolman. Bobby Abrams, number 50, also applying pressure. And Dolman now has 12 and a half sacks. A
couple of different ways linemen get sacks. They get it because of great pressure and beating the people up front, or the secondary does a great job of coverage. Here's a case where Chris Dolman doesn't quit. Montana steps up. Dolman finishes him off, gets credit for the sack. Great job by the secondary of the Vikings.
And John Ault will probably be going man-to-man without any help against Dolman all night. That was not his fault. Allen on third and long, absolutely nothing. John Randall wrapped him up behind the line of scrimmage.
John Randall has 11 and a half sacks, but he also is a run defender. Number 93 right in the middle. Right there, he's just going to fire right through. You see him get the penetration, and that's what creates problems. That's what Tim Grunard, their center of Kansas City, was telling us last night. That's the thing that concerned him.
Brian Barker comes on to punt. And Anthony Parker waits at his 10. Returnable kick. All the way up to the 22. And there's a flag on the play. A 33-yard kick, a return of 6. We'll check the penalty. Eric Anderson, downfield on special teams, made the stop. And a solid one it was. Indication it is against the Vikings.
Got a holding call against the Vikings.
Holding number 91 receiving team during the kick. 10 yards from the spot of possession change, first down.
Greg Minuski, the special teamer, he's called for the hold.
No way!
One of the league's tough guys trying to talk his way out of a penalty, it won't work. 3-0, back in a moment.
Now, Golf Digest, the number one magazine in golf, introduces something guaranteed to lower your score. 8 ways to a better golf game. It can help you experience a game you always knew you had inside of you. A game that can make you better off the tee. Better out of the sand. Better on the green. Better all around. Experience the game that's inside of you. Get the 8 ways to a better golf game video. It's guaranteed to improve your game, and it's free with your paid subscription to Golf Digest. That's right, free. If you think you can do without it, think again.
Order 12 issues of Golf Digest for just $19.77 now and get the latest video free. Call 800-544-1000. That's 800-544-1000.
Jumpin', jammin', smashin', crashin', floorin', soarin'. Experience the high-flying world of Supercross like never before. Call now to order Supercross Thrills and Spills, the video that captures the highs and the lows of the world's top riders. Endless endos, roughest rivalries, biggest bloopers, and fantastic finishes. Can't miss action for the can't miss price of $19.95 plus shipping and handling. Call 1-800-225-5222 and order Supercross Thrills and Spills. All major credit cards accepted. Call now.
3:52 to go first quarter. Minnesota leading Kansas City 3-0. Mike Patrick and Joe Theismann with you the day after Christmas. Happy holidays to you and yours.
Happy holidays. Hope everybody had a wonderful Christmas. I know that there are some teams out there that looked under their Christmas tree and saw some victories today that really makes it a great, great new year and playoff opportunity.
That was Bernard Daphne, the left tackle. He started the last couple of weeks in place of rookie Everett Lindsey, who's hurt. The time of the year when people have to fill in and step up. Graham on the carry. And everybody waiting for him. Tracy Rogers makes the stop. Last week, the Vikings got some outstanding production out of their offensive line, a season high in rushing. They did not allow a sack against the Green Bay Packers, who had a ton of them today.
The Vikings, in general, as an offense, are not a fast offense. And I think they play well like they did in conditions last week in Green Bay. On turf like this, I don't know whether it suits them offensively to be as productive.
Second and nine, McMahon to throw, four-man rush, dumps it short, Jordan. The tight end has the first down after the 24-yard line. Again, Tracy Rogers had to make the tackle.
See, I think Jim McMahon needs a running game to be functional. I think in this game, you can use the running game to offset the pass rush and utilize. I think he's got to throw first like that. This is great. They work Jordan underneath the linebackers. He finds the crease, picks up 11 yards, and that's all they want to do is move the chains. Keep Montana on the sidelines, move the chains, put points on the board.
For Jordan, his 51st catch, he had only 28 last year. And Neil Smith, who leads the NFL in sacks, loading up. Play action. McMahon on the roll to Derek Tennell. To the 39-yard line, Martin Bayless made the stop. But the tight ends have already had a featured spot in the Minnesota offense.
Well, I think they have to. I don't think you're going to get a lot of passes completed to the wide receivers. This is an excellent job of play fake. That's what happens when you can run the football. Bayless comes up to try and make a play. Tennell makes the catch, and they wind up with another first down, working it inside the numbers.
First and 10 for the Vikings.
Back to a three wide receiver set, and Jordan a single tight end. Graham, the single running back. And Scotty Graham, straight ahead. Found a seam, got it out near the 45-yard line. Tripped up by Derek Thomas, who came back from his rush linebacker spot.
Brian Billick, the offensive coordinator. They finally have the offense. Brian told me they finally have the offense they thought they would have once they got settled down. That is, McMahon's healthy, using his smarts, and he's got a running game to support him so he doesn't wind up in long yardage situations on third down.
Second and four here. Graham behind Tennell. Sandwiched as he got to the 47-yard line. Lonnie March, the first man to hit him, number 51.
The Vikings are one of the few teams left in the National Football League that employ some type of a trapping offense. What's going to happen is you're going to see again, you're going to see the movement this way by the interior line, and you're going to see somebody get kicked out. There goes the guard, pulls, kicks out. Tennell kicks out. Scotty Graham has really made a reputation for running inside, but tonight he must feel pretty quick because he's bounced two outside.
Third and two for the Vikings at their 47.
Third and two. The Vikings trying to continue this drive. They were very impressive the first time they had it. McMahon, seeing the play clock run, uses a timeout. 3-0, first quarter.
Classic television.
Hogan's Heroes.
Green Acres.
Arnold Ziffer. Who played him?
Nobody. He was the pig.
Remember Family Affair?
Mr. French.
I loved him.
Pete.
He was attractive.
Pete, Link, Julie. Okay, Ginger or Marianne?
Ginger was a bimbo.
Marianne.
Marianne or Jeannie?
Beechwood Age Budweiser.
Jeannie.
Crisp, clean, classic.
Rimology by Shaquille O'Neal. The engineers worked the numbers. They figured and refigured. They said it was indestructible. They said it was Shaq-proof. Maybe they should check their math.
These days, people who want to save money on lunch are brown bagging it. Because McDonald's original hamburger is still just 59 cents. Our delicious cheeseburger is 69 cents. And that is no baloney. Now McDonald's always has one extra value meal for $2.99. Might be this one, this one, this one. Or to find out which extra value meal is $2.99, go to your local McDonald's. Because if you want to know, you gotta go. Come on, no food fights.
Minnesota leads it 3-0 over Kansas City with 22 seconds to go here in Minneapolis at the Metrodome. And the passing yards so far, 54-10 for Kansas City. One turnover in the ballgame. That was a Joe Montana interception. Only his fifth of the season. On the sideline talking with Dave Craig. Third and two for the Vikings. Four-man rush. McMahon steps up in the pocket, tries to run for it. He'll be very, very close depending on the spot. He doesn't run nearly as much as he used to, but he's still effective.
And he's going to get a first down. All he had to do was get to the 50, and he got it.
You know he would have loved to play football in the 40s and 50s without a face mask. He's that kind of guy. At the end of the first period, 3-0, Vikings.
Pool, the Masters way, and
it's last call, last call, last call for all truck buyers, because the Dodge Ram giveaway ends Friday, December 31st. It's your last chance to win a new 94 Dodge Ram at your nearest participating Dodge dealer. And don't miss your chance to own a hard-to-get 94 Dodge Ram from our special factory allotment, because the Dodge Ram countdown is ending soon, too. Yes, it's your last call for the Dodge Ram countdown, so don't miss it. Get there before the truck you want is gone. See your nearest Dodge dealer today.
Here's what we have to do. First, you cut here, then here, here, and here. You need to think about what you're doing. The cuts have to be precise. I don't want any extra fat, just lean, healthy meat. To measure up to our standards, every Price Chopper steak has to be 1/8-inch trim. Do you understand?
Yes, sir!
Well, then go get them.
Price Chopper's 1/8-inch trimmed meat makes a lot of sense.
You know, the closest thing I ever tasted to my mom's biscuits are Hardee's biscuits. Made from scratch. Big, fluffy, and buttery taste. Just like I like them. Just like mom's.
Sausage biscuit and gravy, or cinnamon raisin two-pack. All just 99 cents.
Oh, yeah.
Biscuits don't get much better than this.
Are you sure you don't know my mom?
Oh, get on out of my kitchen, girl.
Just like my mom.
Are you ready for some real food? Hardee's.
Welcome back to the Metrodome, and now a word from our resident wise man, Mr. Ross Perot.
Ross here, and a tender season's greetings to you and yours. Now, down to business. McMahon and Montana, these two have about as much in common as Democrats and Republicans, with one exception. These guys get it done. Here's the deal. With Montana at QB, the Chiefs are 7-2. Without them, 3-2. McMahon, same difference. Vikes with them, 6-3. Without them, 1-4. Friends. I call this product enhancement. History bears me out. When the rubber meets the road, you can't find a better pair. Bottom line is the bottom line. Ain't that right, Mike?
He calls me Mike. I call him Mr. Perot. That's relative of our status.
I didn't realize you two guys were such close friends.
Only from my end. First and 10 Vikings. Play action with me. He'll run it again. And gets five and slides safely into second base. They have both been extremely successful throughout their careers. The top two winning percentages, Montana over 72, McMahon nearly at 70. But certainly Pro Bowls, Super Bowls, and 300-yard games, the huge advantage to Joe Montana.
Well, I think the last two Pro Bowls and 300-yard games really are a product of the system.
Exactly.
You get voted to the Pro Bowl by putting numbers up, and that's the same way you get 300-yard games.
Second and five, Graham hit by Thomas and Rogers.
What Jim McMahon has always been a part of as far as offensive philosophy goes is run the ball and let me throw for production. And that's exactly what he's done as a pro. Now, in college, of course, he has the ability to throw 84 TDs, 34 interceptions, and a passing system at BYU. Jim McMahon could have the big, big, huge numbers, except he just never has been given an opportunity to.
But despite the system, he has still posted the wins. Good protection again. McMahon throws complete. First down at the 32, Chris Carter. Covered by Kevin Ross, but McMahon squeezed it in there and took a shot for his trouble.
vertically, and Kevin Ross is a corner. What's going to happen is the Vikings are going to have to run routes across the field, clear people out, run the ball across the field, make the corners chase you. Don't allow them to go out and just jam you. Carter comes across. Now you see, now you make them chase you. Clean it out and go across the middle of the field. That's what you want to do.
And McMahon has to use yet another timeout. Their second here early in the first half. We'll be back to Minneapolis in a moment.
Okay, class. If a pizza with three toppings costs $10.99, what would I pay for six toppings?
$12.99, $15.99, $18.99.
Well, anyone? $10.99. Huh? The reason is...
It's the Bigfoot Big Six Pizza. Get our special six toppings for the three-topping price of $10.99.
Are you sure you're the Pizza Hut guy?
Bigfoot from Pizza Hut, a legendary value.
Of the original.
Now for the Levi's Loose Jeans player of the day.
When you're a cornerback and you return not one, but two interceptions for a touchdown, as Eric Allen of the Eagles did against the New Orleans Saints, making it four for the year, tying yourself with Ken Houston and Jim Kearney for an NFL record, that's why, Mike and Joe, you're the player of the day.
Boy, he deserved it too, didn't he, Chris? Just a brilliant season for Eric Allen. Coming up, the Thrifty Car Rental Bowl Week. Begins Tuesday night at 8, first of six straight days of bowl action. Liberty Bowl as Louisville battles Michigan State. Wednesday night then at 7:56, the Copper Bowl, number 20, Kansas State against Wyoming. Thursday night at 8, the Holiday Bowl, number 11, Ohio State against BYU. Friday afternoon, 12:30, the Independence Bowl, Virginia Tech and Indiana. Friday night at 6, the Peach Bowl, number 24, Clemson against Kentucky. At 9:30, the Alamo Bowl, California against Iowa. And it all ends on New Year's. Year's morning, 11 a.m., the Hall of Fame Bowl, number 23, Michigan, against North Carolina State. Whew. Gee, Scotty Graham run out of bounds after a gain of a couple. There's a flag down. That's a lot of bowl games, huh?
Mike, if you were a player, you'd be on the bench right now sucking in some oxygen.
Check the penalty for you. And it will go against the Vikings.
And this is what Dennis Green has wanted to avoid. He does not want to get his team in long yardage situations.
Building formation, offense, two eligible receivers on the line of scrimmage on the left side of the line. The penalty is declined, second down.
You know, that absolutely baffles me. You come from a timeout on the sidelines. You have all that time for the team to be on the field. You walk into a huddle. You got all the time in the world to call the play in the formation. And guys don't get it right. That absolutely baffles me. I'm sure it baffles Brian Billick as well.
Decline the penalty. So it's second and about 11. McMahon throws the quick slant. It's picked off. Intercepted by Kevin Ross on the ricochet. And Kevin Ross with the 30th interception of his career.
Boy, did Santa Claus drop one in Kevin Ross's lap. This is an excellent ball. This is an excellent thrown ball. It just winds up in the air. Kevin Ross from the safety position is aggressive. Watch the left part of your screen. Here comes the quick post. AC goes off his chest. He doesn't want to get hit. Kevin Ross just happens to be running there. The ball hits him in the chest. Watch this. Up. Hit me in the chest. I'm going to tackle him, and all of a sudden he's got a ball in his hand.
Ross moved to safety, had been a corner and a brilliant one, and they have some great coverage guys back there now. First and 10 from the 27. The fullback, Kimball Anders, fumble. The Vikings have it. McMillan makes the fumble recovery, so turnovers on back-to-back plays.
Roy Barker, number 92, is going to strip him of the ball. You see him do a great job of coming hard inside. That's what that defensive line does. They just rush people and stick their arms out if running backs go by. And McMillan's there to jump on the loose ball.
Vikings set up shop at the 31. Take the reverse. McMahon deep. Chris Carter. Touchdown! There's a flag down, but it looks like it will be interference against Dale Carter.
Pass interference, number 34, defense, penalty declined, touchdown.
Great throw, great catch.
Good play selection. They fake the reverse to Anthony Carter, and they let Chris run a corner on Dale Carter. It's fake to Carter, Carter cover, Carter catch, touchdown Carter. That's a perfectly thrown ball, brought it in over the top. Let the guy make a play on the ball.
Fouad Reves with the point after. And Chris Carter with his 8th touchdown catch of the year.
When people work together, they get more done. When people work together, they save time and money. That's why every Macintosh computer comes with networking built in. Sort of makes you wonder why other computers don't.
Doesn't it feel so sharp? Doesn't it feel on the mark? Doesn't it feel good to pay less?
Who's got the latest men's shoes on sale? Pay less.
Doesn't it feel like leather, so put together? Doesn't it feel good to pay less?
Men's leather loafers, dress shoes, and hikers starting at a very comfortable $19.99. Better step on it.
Doesn't it feel good to pay less?
I really enjoyed it tonight.
Oh, I had a
it was a great party, great fun with food.
Yes, I had a wonderful time. The stars are so beautiful tonight.
Yeah, they light up the sky. Hey, you know, we gotta do this more.
I think so.
Next time.
Spend the evening on January 8th, gazing at the stars as Budweiser brings you the 14th consecutive Lou Rawls Parade of Stars to benefit United Negro College Fund.
ESPN's Sunday Night NFL is brought to you by Budweiser, Beechwood Age for a crisp, clean, classic taste, and by Payless Shoe Source.
Kansas City defensive backfield huddling on the sideline. They were burned on that one and are down 10-0 early in this ballgame. Reves kicking to McNair, who fumbled, and Dan Hughes. And Hughes will take it at the 9. And Hughes back to the 29-yard line.
On this particular replay, the fake by Anthony Carter, McMahon fakes, but watch Derek Thomas. He's barely going to get anywhere. Carter's going to come in, Chris, and head for the corner. The play action and the blocking by the line up front of it really sells it. McMahon has a lot of time to make a great thing. You know, Jim McMahon really is an excellent passer. He's just been never given an opportunity to show his skills.
McNair, who was in on the kickoff, had fumbled, and Carter, the man burned for the touchdown. Kansas City has only 30 yards in offense so far. Anders, looking at about 43 in total offense, taken out of bounds by Carlos Jenkins.
Mike, that's the Kansas City offense. What we saw in that one stretch in the first quarter where they ran the ball a lot is not Paul Hackett's style, the offensive coordinator, and it's not what Joe Montana does best. He play actions the best in the National Football League. He and Boomer Esiason do. But moving the ball in a rhythm is what he wants to do. And that's what Paul Hackett told me before. I've got to get my offense in some semblance of a rhythm.
keep it on the ground with John Stevens, and he's shoved back.
John Stevens.
A little pushing and shoving going on. Hope you'll be with us noon Sunday. NFL Game Day, Chris Berman, Tom Jackson, Chris Mortensen, and Joe Theismann will update you on everything that's going on in the afternoon. Then at 7, prime time, you'll see all the highlights of all the games. Then at 8 o'clock, Joe and I will be at the Astrodome as the Jets, who are still alive, will battle the AFC Central champion, the hottest team in football, the Houston Oilers. Job by Stevens as flags go down. He picked his way through several tacklers.
I just don't see anybody running well wide against either one of these defenses, Mike. They have too much speed to chase the ball to be successful running wide.
And this play will come back. Stevens getting some unusual activity. It only carried twice before tonight.
Holding, number 85, offense, 10 yards, repeat second down.
There's Marcus Allen on the sideline. We haven't seen him very much at all lately. We understand he is not injured. Got four carries for 9 yards early. Marty Schottenheimer says he will see action about 60% of the time in this offense. Montana.
Chance to take a shot downfield. Davis just doesn't come up with the ball. Excellent job by the offensive line. I mean, they made it a point that they were going to protect their man, Joe. Now, there's Davis. He's going to go for the ball, but he just doesn't make a play. Has a shot at it. I mean, that's the difference between advancing and winning games or struggling is making plays.
Third and long, the Chiefs. Fifth best team in the NFL. And Montana has to use a timeout. And that 40-second clock is driving me nuts. We'll talk more about that as we go along.
You drive a car like this and you're going to be asked a lot of questions. Like, what kind of car is that? You say, it's Eagle Vision TSI. They say, oh yeah, a Jeep Eagle. To which you respond, it's not a Jeep Eagle. That's where you buy it. Then you tell them all about its performance technology. Eagles do invite a lot of questions. But the next time someone calls an Eagle Vision a Jeep Eagle, you can tell them where to go.
See your local Jeep and Eagle dealer.
Attention Greyhound fans, following the Woodlands annual Christmas break, the track reopens on Monday night with an all-new schedule. By popular demand, the new schedule includes racing every Wednesday through Monday. That's 6 days a week, with doubleheaders on Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday. Plus simulcasting from some of the top horse racing tracks in America. Catch reopening night on Monday, December 27th, and a New Year's Eve doubleheader on Friday the 31st.
I awoke from a daydream, so I guess I was never asleep. Something was building, and I'm not talking pothole construction. I never fix those. I'm talking burrito urge. Beans, cheese, chili, guacamole, and anything else you can pack into a tortilla before stuff falls over the edges onto my bobbly-headed dashboard dog. Moments later, I fulfilled my brazen hunger with those Taco Bell burritos. And with hot sauce dripping down my chin, I realized I was eating the dream.
Cross it.
Jim McMahon and Joe Montana, two veteran, very knowledgeable quarterbacks, and yet between them, they've burned three timeouts here in the first half. Why?
I don't blame the quarterbacks. The 40-second clock has put more pressure on sideline management. Coaches calling plays, signaling them in, and coaches having their packages, their player packages, substituted fast. Marty Schottenheimer, Dennis Green, every coach in the National Football League will do a better job next year once they understand that they're going to have to speed up the packages. And the signal.
Third and 18 for Kansas City. Excellent protection from Montana. Then goes short to J.J. Purdy.
and he can't run for it. Knocked out of bounds at the 46-yard line. Anthony Parker made the stop and got some help.
John Alt, number 76, a left tackle, and Chris Dolman, number 56, lock it up here. Alt does a great job of just riding Dolman where he wants to go. He's got a little bit of jersey, not a lot, but he takes him down hard inside, allows Joe to step up to where the throwing lane is and make the pass.
Parker comes on to punt, and Parker retreats inside his 15-yard line. Kansas City has just been unable to move the football. Parker cartwheeled at the 10. There's a flag down on the play back at the 30. Todd McNair with the big hit. 7-yard return after a punt of 50. We'll check the flag with Gordon McCarter.
Illegal block in the back. There's something different.
Number 86 receiving team during the return. Half the distance, first down.
So when Minnesota takes over, they'll be deep in their own territory, leading 10-0.
Sporting goods in one place. Kmart.
In an age of anonymous luxury cars, a Jaguar remains defiantly individual. Because Jaguar has a design philosophy that doesn't change with the wind. Details on the new Jaguar Dream Lease, see your local dealer.
We've helped over 1 million people live a better life with consumer loans. And millions more plan for retirement. We've provided the security of life insurance for 15 million lives. And while we'd like to be known for all the things we've done, we're still a little better known for our building.
In Bloomington, Minnesota, 78 acres. It cost $625 million to build, 325 stores. It has its own theme and amusement park. It is something to behold. It has become an enormous tourist attraction in the Twin City area. Vikings from their own 5, Scotty Graham. Bowles his way out to the 9. Tough run.
You know, Mike,
the young man from Ohio State.
Kansas City defense, they're catching. Now, they're catching the Vikings. They're catching the Viking runner. You saw Graham get hit and move ahead. Neil Smith and that defensive line, I don't think they can stop the Vikings run game by having the 4 guys up front. When you've got somebody backed up like this and you got a quarterback that's not real mobile and great corners, I think you've got to blitz them. You've got to put pressure on. You have to dictate the tempo. You can't let them do it. Right now, Minnesota's dictating tempo.
Second and 6 for the Vikings. McMahon a little half roll to Scotty Graham, and he is wrapped up in a hurry by Lonnie March, the right outside linebacker.
Something else on that on the Kansas City defense. Derek Thomas is now playing a different position. Derek Thomas is playing what's called the down rush backer, for lack of a better description. They're listed as a 3-4 defense with 3 big guys, but he's really the 4th guy. And I talked to Dave Adolph earlier today, and he said that Derek Thomas makes big plays when he's rushing the passer, when he's putting pressure on him. His sacks are down, but he's playing an overall better game this year.
He really fought the move. Third and two. McMahon hangs in the pocket. Chris Carter, first down out to the 23-yard line. Charles Mincy made the tackle.
The other thing is, Derek Thomas has got such a reputation as a pass rusher. He's not going to get blocked by one person. He's going to get blocked by two. Daphne runs him outside. Scotty Graham runs him a little bit further around McMahon. Jimmy steps up. And the Vikings are executing their game plan to perfection. 3 yards, 3 yards, completion, move the sticks.
The double team is a point that Neil Smith made to us last night. That Thomas hasn't had a chance to get that many sacks because of the blocking. Graham cuts it outside again. And Chris Carter threw him an outstanding block downfield.
And Bernard Daphne on the left side and Mike Tice, number 87, are doing a great job on the left side on Lonnie Marks. That's the third time they've run outside on Marks. There's Tice, there's Daphne. They're going to take the ball and run outside, but there's number 51, Marks. He just is getting eaten up. He closes it down. Daphne just muscles him. He's had outside position all three times, and they've run outside him still.
The Vikings have been very impressive on offense and lead 10-0. Graham to the 40-yard line, and that time, Tim Newton, number 96, ran right by him.
Got a player down. A chief is down and hurt pretty bad.
It is Derek Thomas. See if the replay will show us how he was injured.
He does a great job of chasing plays down. Oh. He sticks his head in and just gets bent back a little. You can see his neck gets snapped back.
Well, those are the ones you're afraid to see. Obviously, he's moving around, which is the first sign you look for.
So she was kicking his legs when he was on the ground. I mean, you don't like to see anybody do that, but if you're hitting the head, movement is very important.
The young man who was the keynote speaker at the Vietnam War Memorial this past year. His father was a fighter pilot in the Vietnam War, killed over there. Says he wants to go back without a lot of people around and see it for himself, just by himself. And glad to see he's up and able to come off under his own power. It's 10-0 Vikings with 7:27 on a turning clock, first half from Minneapolis. The Vikings looking for two wins. If they get them, they're in the playoffs. Graham bobbled the handoff and got about a yard, and that's it. Simeon, the middle linebacker, and Tracy Rogers, the outside linebacker, combined on the tackle.
Tracy Simeon, number 54, is really an underrated linebacker. He's right smack dab in the middle. There he is. Now watch him make the move. He sees this play. He reads it. He comes up. He fills. He makes the initial hit.
Became a starter with his club as a rookie. 6'1", 250. Third and four for McMahon. They have eaten almost all the time off the first half clock. Kansas City comes with a blitz. They pick it up, and McMahon completes the pass to Ismail, first down.
See, I just don't agree with Kansas City's defensive philosophy in this drive at all. I mean, when you only have 3 yards to pick up and you blitz, that's not a big deal. But what the offensive line is doing is they're giving McMahon a chance to step up and throw the football. Watch how this pocket is formed. See the area that Jim has to step up into? He steps up. I mean, they're running a 3-yard crossing route, and you're just not putting any pressure on the quarterback. You got to do it on first and 10, not third and three.
5:52 to go in the half. Vikings already up 10-0. Scotty Graham to midfield. Word on Derek Thomas. He has a burner in his left shoulder. He will probably be back.
know, Mike, you look down this offensive line of the Minnesota Vikings, Daphne, McDaniel, Schreiber, Kalis, Irwin, Jordan, when Tice goes in there, a lot of experience there. A very, very good offensive line. And when you're running the football, that's the kind of play discrepancy you can create. 31-16 in Minnesota's favor.
And Minnesota comes in ranked 21st in the National Football League in rushing. They're not looking like it tonight. McMahon, smart job, just threw it out of bounds. Dan Saliamoa applying the pressure at 300 pounds plus up the middle.
Jim McMahon felt the pressure that time, had to unload it. Look at how wide open Anthony Carter's going to get. Great job of beating Albert Lewis at the line, loses him at the line, loses him out of the route. Unfortunately, McMahon did not have time, and AC looked around and didn't see anybody.
Third and six for the Vikings at midfield.
The Vikings, 27th in the league overall. Look at tonight. 6 of 7. They face third and six here. Four-man rush. Plenty of time. Can't find anybody. Now sidearms it to Jordan, and he stopped well short. Nice defense by Doug Terry coming in on the nickel and dime defense for Kansas City.
That's what Jim McMahon gives you. He avoided the negative play and wound up with just a one-yard gain, but it wasn't a sack, and it gave the defense not a big lift, didn't give Kansas City a lift. He lets his defense go out on the field and play some more football.
Harry Newsom comes on to punt. J.J. Burden waits at the 10. 4:19 to go in a rapidly moving first half. Newsom, high sailing spiral. Fair catch, made it the 11-yard line. And Burden was bumped. Will it get a flag? It will not. A punt of 37, no return. Joe Montana and his offense down by 10.
There are only a few ways to make big league money with a ball. Most of them are not easy. To make millions with a basketball, you have to be very good. To score big in football, you've got to be good and tough. Baseball, to get big numbers, you've got to have great numbers. But Missouri Powerball is anybody's game. Easy to play. Just pick 5 numbers plus 1 more for the Powerball. Win, and you're into millions. Powerball from the Missouri Lottery. It's big league money.
The best truck news of the year just got even better. Not only can you get the best lease ever on any new 1994 Ford F-Series, now you can get the lowest financing rate of the year, 2.9% on any 1993 or 1994 model Ford F-Series truck. So whether you buy or lease, you won't find a better offer than this. Your Ford dealer has a good selection of America's best-selling pickups. But don't wait. This offer ends January 3rd. So hurry to get the best of terms on America's best at your Ford dealer today.
You know, the closest thing I ever tasted to my mom's biscuits are Hardee's biscuits.
Made from scratch. Big, fluffy, and buttery taste. Just like I like them. Mmm. Just like mom's.
Sausage biscuit, biscuit and gravy, or cinnamon raisin two-pack. All just 99 cents.
Oh, yeah.
Biscuits don't get much better than this.
Are you sure you don't know my mom?
Oh, get on out of my kitchen, Carl.
Just like my mom.
Are you ready for some real food? Hardee's.
Derek Thomas on the left, Chris Dolman on the right, two of the premier pass rushers in the National Football League. But a discrepancy with how they perform and where.
Well, the thing is, look at the sacks for Dolman at home. 51 and only 36 and a half on the road. Thomas, almost twice as much, 45 to 21. That has to do with crowd noise. The tackles cannot hear very well, so they can't hear the snap count. All they can do is focus on these guys. These guys are so quick. Both of them play on AstroTurf, and the crowd gives them that little bit of an edge coming off the ball.
Joe Montana has only thrown for 41 yards in the first half. Chased by Dolman, now chased by Tuaola, and got out of bounds in front of Carlos Jenkins, who had a bead on him.
Watch Chris Dolman. All he does is take John off and give him a pull rush and just take that one left-handed paw and swat him aside and force Montana out of the pocket for a minimal gain.
Ernie Thompson, 45. John Stevens, 21. Check into the Kansas City backfield. Stevens, no place to go. This Kansas City offense has had no luck running against Minnesota's defense, which allows only 99 yards a game.
Well, that the front four are so aggressive. When you try and create a blocking lane, it's filled all of a sudden by one of the tackles. You know, John Randall, number, for example, 93, he just takes that hard inside, and there's nowhere to go. And what they do is they spill the backs out to the linebackers waiting for them.
Even though these guys will admit they don't think about stopping a run, they're after the quarterback. And they'll have a shot on third and six. Marcus Allen in the flat. What a play by McMillan. Audrey McMillan with the big stop will force another punt.
Montana reads the defense. As he looks down the field, he sees the drops. He doesn't have what he wants to the left. Swings it out to Marcus. You got to figure it's a decent bet one-on-one. McMillan makes the single tackle.
Montana just handcuffed so far in the first half. Barker is on to punt. Parker waits at his own 40. End over end, returnable kick from the 45. Flag is down as he gets to the Kansas City 46-yard line after a 9-yard return. And we'll check the call from Gordon McCarter. We have 2:17 to go in the first half. If you just joined us, it's been all Minnesota offensively and defensively. They lead it 10 to nothing. Penalty will go against the Vikings.
Illegal block in the back. 82 receiving team. During the return, 10 yards, first down.
There's Andre McMillan, who made the big tackle on that last play. He's a young man who was invested in the Houston ghetto apartment building and tried to clean it up and help the people who live there. He said, I have reached a level of personal success in one profession, but I haven't even started fulfilling my purpose as a man. I'm trying to add happiness to others' lives. And there are so many guys in this league who do so much for so many people that make their lives richer, and you very seldom hear about it. McMahon on first down. The quick out, and Ismael did not go out, and it looks like he's upset at himself.
Well, there's a question of whether McMahon wanted to throw to an area, or was it an audible to an out, or was it a hitch? Now, that's the question. A hitch is a 5-yard stop. An out would be a 5-yard out. You can see Ismael put his hands up towards his ears. Jimmy audible. He couldn't hear it.
And that's at home.
Yeah. A lot of guys use hand signals for that. They touch their face mask, they point at their ear or something.
Second and 10 from the 44. Draw to Graham. Not this time. Sally Amoa wraps him up as he crossed the 45-yard line. And Jim McMahon will go to the sidelines to talk over what they want to try on third and eight. We've hit the 2-minute warning. Still 10-0.
This is an American car, the Eagle Vision TSI, a unique sports sedan with a 24-valve, 214-horsepower engine, speed-sensitive steering, even driver and front passenger airbags. And thanks to Eagle Vision, a lot of people who used to buy imports are now deciding to buy American. Now, if you could just do the same for that television you're watching.
See your local Jeep and Eagle dealer.
Kansas City Price Chopper is your New Year's holiday one-stop for the best food at the best price every day. Check out these holiday specials. Enjoy USDA-inspected Freshling Brown Chuck in the family pack, $1.19 a pound. Heinz ketchup in the 28-ounce squeeze bottle, 99 cents. Assorted varieties of Guy's potato chips in 14.5-ounce bags are 2 for $3. And bring your film to any Casey Metro Price Dropper for the best price on professional film developing. It makes good sense to shop Price Dropper.
Hey!
What?
I don't think it's gonna fit the billboard.
Gotta fit.
Presenting McDonald's double quarter pounder with cheese, with two juicy quarter pound patties of beef.
Okay, it fits.
Where are you gonna put the fries and the Coke?
The what?
With large golden fries and a medium Coke, it's our new double quarter pounder with cheese extra value meal.
Okay, fit.
Now where are you gonna put the arches?
The what?
What you want is what you get.
The double quarter pounder with cheese extra value meal.
At McDonald's today.
2 minutes to go, first half. Minnesota leading Kansas City 10-0. Coming up at halftime, the fastest 3 minutes in television with Chris Berman. After review, Chris and Tom Jackson take a look at a couple of things, including Sterling Sharp's remarkable performance again. Back to the Metrodome for Joe's first half analysis of this one. Kevin Ross, we're told, has a hip pointer, and his return is in question. Ross moved from corner to safety. Really helped the secondary and had an interception earlier here in the first half. Third and eight, four-man rush. McMahon intended for Roger Craig, but Benny Thompson covered him beautifully out of the backfield.
Well, Kansas City's defense has done their job. Minnesota's offense, the whole first half, has done theirs. Now is when you get into when Joe Montana has established himself as one of, I mean, he is the greatest that's ever played the game, but in the two-minute end of half, end of game scenarios, this is where he's, again, reestablished his greatness.
Harry Newsom into punt. Dale Carter waits at his own 10-yard line with a minute 54 to go in the half. No rush. Newsom with a high flowing kick. Carter, no fair catch. Broke a couple of tackles, can't break a third. Brought down at the 18. A return of three. Greg Minuski makes the tackle on special teams. These are the two winningest active quarterbacks in the NFL. And McMahon having much the better of it with 117 yards passing to only 44 for Joe Montana. Both have had a pick here in the first half.
And, you know, McMahon's pick really wasn't. That was Anthony Carter short-armed that one. But now what Montana says, he's got to move the ball in a rhythm down the field.
Plenty of time. Throws short. Complete. Willie Davis will get maybe 6 yards out of it.
It's important for Joe Montana to get a couple of first downs, not just for him, but for his teammates to get a sense that they've got something going. They can't be shut down here.
They have two timeouts left. Four-man rush. Montana again short. Kimball Anders.
That's just bad football right there. Kimball Anders had the first down. You got to understand where you are in the field and where you are in the game.
Ran backwards.
He ran
Dave
backwards.
Garnett got him.
Lost 3 yards.
Kansas City burning a lot of time here. Short pass to McNair, and he's knocked out of bounds at the 32-yard line.
See, Ambers cost Joe Montana 25 seconds. If he had gotten the first down, Joe could have run up to the line and spiked the ball. Instead, he's got to redirect people and come up with a third down conversion play. That creates problems for the offense and the quarterback. Now you got 53 seconds. Joe loves to run the quick posts with the outside receivers and the inside receivers out towards the sidelines. It's part of his offense. He's got a game. He's got to get some pass in here that'll gain 15 or 20 yards.
John Stevens comes in as a running back and goes to a wing. Montana deep over the middle, almost picked again. Right in the hands of Lamar McGriggs, and there's a flag down in the secondary, and Vincey Glenn is going nuts. Vincey Glenn. Sh- showed us about a 40-inch vertical jump when the flag went down. He went straight up.
Well, Montana tried to get that big chunk that he needed to get his team in position to score. That's a 30-yard penalty if it's going to be roughing. They're probably going to call Vincey for hitting with the helmet. I mean, that's the only thing I can think of. Because what happens is it's a great job knocking the ball away, and then Glenn's just trying to make a play on the receiver. Now McGriggs, 37, knocks the ball away. Great job by him. Vincey Glenn just sticks his shoulder in the chest and makes a hit. Now we don't have replay. You see that? He's not hitting with his helmet. That's just great hard-hitting football.
Oh, unnecessary roughness. Number 25 on the defense.
What they're saying is that play was over. The ball was already knocked down. And Vincey Glenn went ahead and took a shot.
That is absolute hogwash and garbage and baloney.
No, I'm not saying I necessarily agree with him. I'm just saying that's what's being called.
That official should pick the flag up. Watch this. This is a great play by McGriggs. And all he does. Heck, if the ball would have gotten to the receiver, it would have been a bang-bang shot,
yes,
by Glenn trying to knock the ball out. Vincey
Glenn, you're right about that.
Has every reason to be upset. Every reason.
And he is still burning.
Now the Vikings can't lose their composure. They've got it. All right, a bad call went against them. And Dennis, I agree with you 100%. Chew them out. They deserve it.
But the penalty only moves it out to the 47-yard line because it's not interference. It's a roughing call. Montana under pressure, screen to Allen. Weaves his way through some tacklers, and that's the experience of Marcus Allen. He knew exactly where the sticks were and dove for it to try to get the first down so they can kill the clock again.
And he also waited for his offensive lineman to make blocks. He didn't run away from them like we see a lot of young backs do.
Kansas City has used its second timeout, and the first time tonight they have been able to cross midfield. Of course, this guy always waiting in the wings, the most accurate field goal kicker in the history of the National Football League.
He's 5 for 9 from 40 to 49 yards and 1 for 1 from 50.
Looks like Vincey has calmed down a little bit. He has had a great year with this club. Thought he should have made the Pro Bowl in 87 and 89, but didn't get it. Hopes he'll make it this time. Came in with 5 picks, tied for 4th in the conference.
He is everywhere he's been, and people have just sort of phased him out, and he's phased himself back in. He's a big play guy.
Yes, he is.
You know, if there's a big play going to be made in the secondary, you can bet Vincey Glenn's going to be somewhere close by.
And I don't want anybody to make a mistake about that hit. That was a totally legal hit that he hit.
Absolutely.
They tell you to see what you hit. He saw it and then destroyed it.
You know, I think the officials have to get used to seeing guys put on good shots. Not every hard hit is not an illegal hit in this league.
Spot the ball just inside the 44-yard line with 36 seconds to go. It is a first down. Montana throws in the flat. He's got the completion to Keith Cash, the tight end. Saw his brother carry a week ago in Indianapolis.
And you got to figure, that took 6 seconds. So what's going to happen offensively? Joe's got to figure, if he can get it off in rhythm, he can run at least 4 more plays and have 6 seconds left on the clock to try for a scoring opportunity. If he can pick up 5 or 6 yards per play, he's going to gain about 30 yards and be easy field goal range for Lowry.
Sidearms it complete to Hayes. He's at the 34-yard line.
Now, I want to explain something. The last time we had the delay, it was not a timeout to Kansas City. It was a measurement that was called. So now they've just used their second timeout. They still have one left.
On that last play, one of the things that they love about Marcus Allen so much is his ability as a blocker in pass protection. And he stood in there against the blitz by Bobby Abrams and stood him straight up.
He's the complete back. There's number 32. He's just going to block. That's what he does. His job is to help out and protect. Slides to the right. Here comes Abrams. Sticks his head in. Does a great job of keeping body position. First of all, Marcus Allen is a future Hall of Famer.
Oh, yeah.
Deserves it. Secondly, you don't find many backs in this game today who are total and complete backs. Marcus Allen, Emmitt Smith, Thurman Thomas. They're every down backs. And you can do so much with your offense if you find a guy who will be on the field first, second, and third down.
Just an exceptional athlete. Never had the blazing speed. He got it done with
and never will.
Body lean. Oh, no. He's not going to get it out there.
You know, he's the kind of guy when I played in the game, I would have loved to have been able to play with. I played with a great one in John Riggins and one in Joe Washington. But he's the kind of guy as a player, you said, boy, it would be great to play with a guy like that.
Montana, after a miserable first half, has hit 6 out of 7 on this drive. Third and a yard. First down, and Moore. Barnett dives inside the 20 to the 19-yard line, gain of 15. Dave Garnett makes the tackle on Tim Barnett, and Kansas City will use its last timeout with 12 seconds to go.
Of course, the fans continue to boo every time a timeout is used because of the hit that Vincey Glenn made and was called a personal foul, which it really wasn't.
In case you joined us late, here's the scoring summary of the ball game to get you up to speed. The Vikings jumped on top 3-0. Fouad Rivet's 22-yard field goal. The captain, nice drive. That was in the first quarter. And then Chris Carter on a beautiful throw from McMahon made it 10-0 in the second quarter. Kansas City's offense has done nothing in the first half until this drive, and they have just reached the Viking 19-yard line.
I think, Mike, Joe Montana has a couple of options. First of all, I think he's got to throw the ball somewhere into the end zone. Secondly, if he's not there, he's got to throw it away because he can't take a sack. And I'm figuring the best way for him to work would be towards the corners. That way you have a chance to throw it away. You can also allow your guy to make a play.
No timeouts left. 12 seconds to go. Davis and Burden both come to the near side. Viking defense wants the crowd to help them. Montana for the end zone. Flag is down, intended for McNair. But it was covered beautifully by Carl Lee, who just got in the way.
And that's going to be an offside penalty, I believe, possibly against John Ault. Just flinched a little bit before the ball was snapped. Just ever so slightly, but the movement caused the offside.
False start before the snap. Number 76, offense. No time elapsed. Please reset the game clock to 12 seconds. 12 seconds on the clock.
That's a great break for Kansas City.
Well, it is, and Marty's saying go for the field goal right now. It is the right call by the official. This is a great job of watching it. Watch number 76 right there. He just flinches just before. You see, the flinch was so quick you could barely pick it up, Mike. But he did. Trust me, he did flinch.
I trust you. Lowry is on the field. I think they made the decision when the clock had gone down to 8 seconds to go for the field goal, and it looks like they will stick with it. Lowry will try from 42. A man who was cut 11 times by 8 different teams early in his career. And he is perfect. And the crowd lets them hear it. It was the penalty that kept that drive alive.
Kansas City offensively executed a drive very well. Minnesota's defense did a great job. And the opportunity for Kansas City was set up by a very, very difficult call. Montana makes the throw down the field. McGriggs knocks it away. Vincey Glenn coming in to deliver a blow on Stevens. And they called unnecessary roughness. I mean, this is a game where people get hit, folks.
The more I see it, the more I agree with your initial point that if Vincey Glenn is playing the man instead of the ball, he never sees the incompletion. He did his job and should not have been penalized.
No, the ball would have been there about the same time. I think Vincey made a great play.
Hope you'll be with us Tuesday night, 7:30, an NFL special for you. For the first time ever, the Pro Bowl Selection Show with Chris Berman, Tom Jackson, and Joe Theismann. We will exclusively and announced this year's Pro Bowl team for both the AFC and the NFC. The first time the fans have had a chance to vote, so see how your choices compare with the players and the coaches. Tuesday night, 7:30 Eastern, the Pro Bowl selection show. And Tony Dungy, the defensive coordinator, was talking with one of the officials during that pause in the action, and you know he didn't like that call.
Well, you know, you got to understand what's at stake right here. I mean, for the Vikings, they've got to win, too, because the Pack and Detroit are already in. And for Kansas City, sure, they're in the playoffs. But if you're in the AFC, you got to have home field advantage. You don't go very far.
You bet.
I mean, history has proven that unless you can play at home. So, you know, one little play here, one little play there results in points. Doesn't help your side.
Ismael waiting up to five. Lowry has it teed up with only 9 seconds to go on the clock. Let's see if they'll kick it deep. And Lowry swips it. Del Rio fields it on the hop inside the 20. And the clock stops with 6 seconds to go. The last scoring drive for the Chiefs, 58 yards, and Lowry finished it off with a 42-yard field goal, a 9-play drive that only took a minute 35. Now, if you're Minnesota, you're going to be happy with the 10-3 lead and just down the ball?
Are you asking or are you telling?
No, I'm asking.
No, I'm telling, yes. Absolutely. You know, you don't want to get cute. You got one timeout left. You're on your own 23-yard line. What you do is you tell Scotty Graham, hey, look, if I'm giving it to you, hold on to it. If I'm Jim McMahon, I kneel back.
Scotty Graham will get it and just plunging forward, making sure to protect the ball. And that'll be the last play. That's the end of the first half. The score, 10-3 Vikings. Let's join Chris Berman for the Acura halftime report.
All right, Michael, thank you. So the Vikings trying to spring an upset on the AFC West champion Kansas City Chiefs, but that would be nothing new in this Week 17 day after Christmas. It was a day in which the Bengals, the Patriots, the Buccaneers, the Seahawks, the Cardinals all won on the same afternoon. You have to go way back in the books to find out when that happened. What else happened? Playoff berth decided. Divisionals decided often when the weather outside was frightful. It's been cold at Rich Stadium before, but never this cold as the Bills hosted the Jets. Wind chill, 33 below. Ronnie Lott was stirring up the heat, though, laying out Billy Brooks. The Jets trailed at 16-14 on third down. They ran far away from the goal line to Johnny Johnson. As a result, in the wind, in the cold, Blanchard, 43 yards, no good. Bills win the AFC East for the fifth time in 6 years, beating the Jets 16-14. Santa's elves helping out. Al Davis's Raiders in the cold. It would get colder. Butler the hit. Reggie White looks like he's in the pivot like Bob Lanier. Dishing the ball off to Leroy Butler. Into the stands. Great scene. Packers in the playoffs for the first time in 11 years. They whitewashed the Raiders. 28-0. Lions at the Bears. It was cold at Lambeau. It was cold at Soldier Field. Jim Harbaugh heated it up for the home squad. Bears love the Detroit Lions 14-13. But Eric Kramer to tie a yellow ribbon to Howard. Touchdown. Lions also clinch a playoff berth, beating the Bears 20-14. Colts at the Patriots. Patriots looking to win three in a row for the first time since 88. They belted the Colts on the ground. Leonard Russell, 100-yard day. He almost had 100 in the first quarter. Corey Kroom with a view, 23 yards. Leonard Russell in the third quarter pours it on. This team lost 9 games by a total of 40 points. Today, Parcells Patriots win by 38 over the Colts. Falcons at the Bengals. The Falcons lead it late. David Klingler, just before the 2-minute warning, showing some good speed. Safe at the 21-yard line. That sets up Klingler to Carl Pickens. Touchdown. Bengals upset the Falcons. The Bengals have won 2 in a row. They went 21-17. This man, well, let's suffice it to say, he was good. Jim Brown watched his old team today at least look good. Vinny was great. Testaverde to Keenan McCardle for a touchdown. To McCardle again. Vinny, 21 of 23. The best percentage in a regular season game. Breaking Kenny Anderson's old mark. The Browns win 42-14. Wayne Phillips' Denver Broncos thought they'd have a laugher against Tampa Bay at Mile High. But Craig Erickson did the laughing. Beautiful play to Dave Moore. The Bucs upset the Broncos 17-10 at Denver. Rick Meyer. No time to wallow in the mire for him and the Seahawks. With Warren hurt, John Vaughn got the call. call, 131 yards rushing against the once formidable defensive-minded Steelers. Meyer, Paul Green, touchdown. Seahawks do what they usually do to the Steelers if the King don't beat them, 16-6. The Saints and the Eagles, Eric Allen. Remember his great return early in the year against the Giants? Well, he picked off not one Steve Walsh pass of the Saints. He picked off two, both for touchdowns. Four on the year, tying an NFL mark. The gutty Eagles keep going, beat the Saints 37-26. Dan Reeves, Giants have been the steadiest team in football. But in the sun at Phoenix, they watch Ron Moore and the Cards churn it up on him against in the ground. Moore, 20-yard run, carrying everyone in the end zone as the old McAuliffe used to look. Dan Reeves' squad didn't have it today. Cards bring the upset 17-6. Waiting in the wings, the Dallas Cowboys. Emmitt Smith, 153 yards. When the Cowboys played Washington week one on Monday night, he wasn't there. Guess what? He was there today. So were the whole Cowboys. Kevin Williams, the punt return, 62 yards. Third straight huge win for Dallas. 38-3 over their arch rival Skins. Facing off against the Giants next week. Tom Jackson joins me when halftime continues. After further review, two teams, a couple players in the central that stepped up big. Plus, a word on the Giants-Dallas game. Stay with me.
This halftime report is presented by Acura. Some things are worth the price.
This message furnished by the National Football League.
Come fly the airline that spans more than half the world. United. Come fly the friendly skies.
Welcome back to halftime. Tom Jackson joins me. A little Yuletide cheer, and the Vikings cheering up their fans. They lead the Chiefs 10-3 at the half. We love that NFC Norris division. The Central, it's been fun, and some teams and some players stepped up after further review. Sterling Sharp of the Green Bay Packers caught 100 balls for the second straight season, and he does them of all kinds, Tommy.
Yeah, you saw him there use his hands in man-to-man coverage to get away from Terry McDaniel. He also has his way of finding every soft spot in the zone, even though he's in the middle of three defenders at times. But the best thing that Sterling Sharp does is once he catches the football, he always makes positive yardage for the offense. Here he turns on McDaniel, drives him down to the one-yard line. Again, you see him catch the out route, turn, look at the speed, the grace, and then the nice cut right there at the goal line and the desire to get in for the TD.
Seven catches today gives him 106 on the air as the Pack clinch a playoff berth. Detroit did the same against Chicago at Soldier Field, and Eric Kramer is the man that Detroit's Wayne Fonts has gone to, and he's come up big, Tom, to the last 3 weeks.
Yeah, winning touchdown drive of the game. Look at the patience that Kramer shows in the pocket. Look at his delivery of the ball. He's a classic quarterback in his style. Nice overhand delivery of the football. unlike a Rodney Pete or an Andre Ware, not trying to get all the yardage at one time, but picking his spots, finding the soft spots in the zone coverage underneath, taking what the defense will give him. There he pumps once and then goes to the defender, to the receiver, even though he's in the middle of three defenders. And then a nice play fake right there at the goal line to get the touchdown to win the game.
Well, both Detroit and Green Bay won. They're both in the playoffs at 9-6. The good thing is they play next week at the Silverdome, which means the champ of that division, either Detroit or Green Bay, will be 10-6. The other team will be a wild card team. Tom, can either team, and they still hope to have Barry Sanders back next week, which would change a lot. Can either Detroit or Green Bay make a move in the NFC playoffs?
Well, I think that Green Bay could go far if Brett Favre will continue to play smart football, not make the kind of mistakes that we were seeing him make 3 weeks ago, the big interception that you don't want at the end of a game. And I'm a firm believer that you have to have a go-to guy to win the Super Bowl, which is what everybody wants to do ultimately, and Sterling Sharp is one of the best go-to guys in this league.
All right, well, the go-to guys certainly abundant on the Dallas Cowboys. Dallas at the Giants next Sunday. Winner will be home throughout the playoffs in the NFC. The loser will host a wild card game, but we'll have to do the rest on the road. Any thoughts on what happened today affecting next week?
Well, I think it's two classic styles, the run and gutsy, the, you know, pounded out football of the New York Giants versus that classic wide open style of the Dallas Cowboys. But I think that so many ball players play the game in their minds. And what happened today is that the Giants lost that mental edge that they could have had going into this game. And all of a sudden, they're going to go in and wondering how they're going to play. The Dallas Cowboys are going to go in feeling like they're confident that they should be the winning team.
Well, some two good finishing games in week 18 in the NFC, and we'll be here to talk about
it. Right.
We've got another half of football tonight. The champs of the AFC West, Chiefs, having their hands full with the Vikings, trying to get in and make it three from the Central in the NFC. Jimmy Mack, Chris Cotta. The Vikings lead the Chiefs 10-3 at the half, back to Minnesota.
Everyone's worried about the healthcare situation. Providing top quality healthcare to the people of Kansas City is harder than ever. That's why Health Midwest is working closely with the health insurance industry as partners, not competitors. If you're paying attention, you know the 12 hospitals of the Health Midwest system are the best chance we have of maintaining quality, controlling cost, and providing choice, which ultimately means better health for the people of Kansas City.
A lot of champagne glasses have been used to prove how smooth a car can be at high speed. Toast is in order for a truck that can do the same. New Dodge Ram. The rules have changed.
Experience how the rules have changed. Take the ultimate test drive at your nearest Dodge dealer.
You know, the closest thing I ever tasted to my mom's biscuits are Hardee's biscuits.
Made from scratch. Big, fluffy, and buttery taste. Just like I like them. Mmm. Just like mom's.
Sausage biscuit, biscuit and gravy, or cinnamon raisin two-pack. All just 99 cents.
Oh, yeah.
Biscuits don't get much better than this.
Are you sure you don't know my mom?
Oh, get on out of my kitchen, Carl.
Just like my mom.
Are you ready for some real food? Hardee's.
Guide to better bowling. Here's the spin. It's the Thrifty Car Rental Bowl Week. Non-stop college bowl game action every day. Every day. We'll strike up the band. You pin down the schedule. The Thrifty Car Rental Bowl Week. The ball gets rolling Tuesday, December 28th. It's your turn. Go bowling pigskin style.
Remember the keys to successful bowling. Concentration and...
This halftime report is presented by American Honda, who has been making quality cars in America for the past 11 years.
10-3, Minnesota over Kansas City here at halftime in Minneapolis. Jim McMahon against Joe Montana, and so far, the edge goes to Jimmy Mack.
He really has. Jimmy Mack has done a great job. And as Jimmy Mack goes, so does the running game of the Minnesota Vikings. I mean, they have to run the football. Here you take a look at the job that Mike Tice does on Derek Thomas. Derek Thomas has been a non-factor, as has Neil Smith. Does a nice job of running them outside. There's the running game that they need. Now, that allows Jimmy Mack to throw the football. Look at the great job up front that they've done, giving him a lane to step up into and make the throws. That's the reason why the Minnesota Vikings have been able to control the tempo of this game the first half.
And we'll be back with a kickoff to start the second half in just a moment.
The new Accord EX Coupe. There's more horsepower. Handling and comfort are perfectly balanced. It has dual airbags and anti-lock brakes. We've taken it about as far as you can go. The new Accord EX Coupe. From Honda.
Minnesota on top of Kansas City, 10-3 as we get ready to start the third quarter play. Jim McMahon directed a couple of very nice scoring drives in the first half, one for a field goal and one for a touchdown pass. Has thrown the ball well and gotten good running production out of his backs. Joe Montana struggled early, but then was very good on the final drive that set up the first Kansas City score, Nick Lowry field goal. Take a look at the halftime stats. Nothing to write home about for either ball club, although you can see the difference, especially in the running game for Minnesota, 68 to 25 yards,
well,
Joe.
I think that's why Minnesota has the lead that they have at 10 to 3, because they've been able to run the football. And, you know, if you don't have to throw, you basically take Derek Thomas out of a game. And I got to be honest with you, Mike, I am not 100% convinced that Derek Thomas down in a three-point stance is the most effective way to use his ability. Let him stand up, call him a rushman or whatever you want, but let him rush from the two stance so he can put some moves on defensive tackles that outweigh him by almost 70, 80 pounds.
Certainly wasn't a move that he embraced. Of course, Neil Smith on the other side has had tremendous success in this particular defense. 15 sacks, leading the NFL.
And he's up against a guy who's just done a great job, Tim Irwin, on that side. I mean, Irwin was looking forward to this game an awful lot and the quality of player that he was going up against.
Qadre Ismail waiting at the goal line for Lowry's kick, and the third quarter is underway. High and short. Roger Craig, one of the up men, will return. And Craig had his feet knocked out from under him at the 27-yard line.
Scotty Graham coming on, and this is the way he's run the football. Four to the left. Nine off a left guard. That's 13 to the left side for 50 yards. Three off the right side off the guard position. And outside, they haven't gotten it at all. You can see they want to run left. You know who's over there? Derek Thomas. That's why. What you do is you run at great speed. Don't run away from him.
Well, he's 242 pounds if you can isolate him there. Graham. In the backfield, they didn't isolate him that time, and he must have heard us talking about.
Well, you know what? He went to the left side that time. Now, there's a switch. I mean, they have the flexibility to move Derek Thomas around. This time, they don't play him on the right. They play him on the left. They try and block. Steve Jordan can't hook him. Irwin tried to pull around. They tried to get outside, but see, he's a penetrator. And that time, he did a great job of getting up the field.
Second and 13 after the loss. Play action by McMahon. Nice fake, a lot of patience. Jordan wide open. All the way to the 38-yard line. It's a gain of 38.
Boy, when you can run the football, you run play action. Linebackers have to respect it. Little counteraction, gets the linebackers up. Jordan absolutely has Lonnie Martz lost in coverage. He got behind him, and Martz couldn't find him. Excellent play fake. Scotty Graham sliding through a little hole as a safety valve. Good job by McDaniels.
Minnesota leading 10-3, bidding for more. And McMahon has to use a timeout. With 13:30 to go in the third quarter, the Vikings use their first timeout.
Now there's a new term for executive privileges, because you can lease the all-new Cadillac DeVille for a single upfront payment of $11,972. For 24 months, that's a savings of $1,484 over Cadillac's already low lease payments. See your Cadillac dealer soon. With terms like these, America's most spacious front-drive sedan can give you even more room to maneuver. Cadillac DeVille, creating a higher standard.
Trouble getting into your jeans? Try RelaxFit jeans from Lee.
ESPN Sunday Night NFL is brought to you by the Lee Apparel Company. With regular, relaxed, and loose-fit jeans and casual pants, Lee is the brand that fits. And by Cadillac and your Cadillac dealer, creating a higher standard.
Minnesota continues to lead Kansas City 10-3. We're in the third quarter in Minneapolis, and we invite you to join us for Thrifty Car Rental Bowl Week starting Tuesday night at 8. The first of six straight days of bowl.